A trip to the moon is not easy. First, the enormous gravitational pull of Earth has to be overcome. Then, hundreds of thousands of kilometers are waiting to be crossed, full of harsh darkness, the intense radiation of the sun, and extreme temperature changes. PT Scientists, a private group of engineers and scientists, are working on mastering this journey, and Audi and Vodafone are supporting them on their mission to the moon. In order to leave the Earth once and for all, the two Audi Lunar Quattro moon rovers are loaded into a custom-built spacecraft, Alina, that will bring them safely to the moon. The rocket launches with an incredible thrust of 7,607 kilonewtons and is soon traveling at 10 times the speed of sound. It takes Alina and the two Audi Lunar Quattro into space and then releases them into a high orbit around the Earth. To leave the Earth's gravity, Alina orbits our planet in ever-growing ellipses. Firing the engines at the exact right moment, it catapults away and starts its 5-day journey to the moon, traveling at speeds of up to 11 kilometers a second. While the moon is often portrayed as being fairly close to Earth, it is in fact around 384,400 kilometers away. That's enough space to fit every other planet in the solar system between Earth and the moon. The spacecraft Alina, carrying the two Audi Lunar Quattro, approaches the moon at high speed and enters its orbit at a precisely calculated angle. Once this task is completed, the spacecraft prepares for the last part of the journey, the landing. PT scientists chose the landing site years ago, the Taurus Littrow Valley near the Apollo 17 landing site, an area well known by scientists and lunar explorers. In science fiction films, landers simply descend to the lunar surface. But in reality, the lander is still orbiting the moon at a speed of 1.7 kilometers a second until the final landing sequence is initiated. The landing is the most crucial part of the journey. While slowly descending, precisely calculated engine burns slow the lander down as it approaches its final landing site. Once Alina has touched down safely on the moon, it establishes a communications link with Earth. It then releases the two rovers, which connect to Alina via an LTE base station that is built with the help of Vodafone. This allows data from the rovers to be relayed from the rovers down to Earth via Alina. Their journey to the moon took more than 9 years of development, planning, and engineering work. Now, the real mission can begin. But what will the rovers do on the moon, and what are the challenges on Earth's ancient satellite? Well, let's take a look at it. The moon is covered with lunar regolith, better known as moon dust. This surface will put the rover's Quattro drive systems to the ultimate test because the sharp fragments that form the moon dust constantly break down into even smaller parts. These are about 1,000 times finer than dust on Earth, a surface on which maximum traction is essential. Moon dust permeates almost everything, and if it enters their gearboxes, the Audi Lunar Quattro won't be able to move and the whole mission will be in danger. One solution, labyrinth seals that redirect the moon dust and protect the rover's sensitive machinery. Because of the low gravity, only 1/6 that of the Earth, the moon dust that is stirred up by the rovers floats around for a long time. It could settle on the solar panels and cover them, which would reduce the amount of energy that can be collected. Another danger to look out for, shadows, which could damage the rovers. That's because of the moon's extreme changes in temperature and lack of atmosphere. The rovers are made from different materials, all of which expand and contract when their temperature changes. If the rovers were to drive into a shadow, they could cool down by 50% of their normal temperature in under 10 minutes. This could lead to parts contracting too fast and ultimately render the rovers immobile. Protecting electronic components from radiation is made extremely difficult by the lack of a magnetic field on the moon. The sun blasts high-energy particles into space, which hit the surface of the moon and the rover's computer systems unfiltered. Most of the time, this will just lead to the computer resetting itself. But in the worst case, a transistor could short-circuit and be destroyed. To avoid this, all systems are constantly monitored and rebooted if an anomaly is detected. The rovers are also fitted with backup systems in case the main systems malfunction. The two Audi Lunar Quattro are carrying scientific payloads and experiments and will pay a visit to explore the Apollo 17 landing site in great detail. All this will provide us with important information far beyond the mission to the moon. And there's another question. Will the rovers survive the long, dark lunar night with temperatures of minus 180 degrees Celsius and see another day on the moon? Only time will tell, but we're looking forward to finding out.